from the HP Pavilion in San Jose, California. Semifinals of the SAP Open. The young up-and-coming American Ryan Harrison taking on the number three seed, the defending champ, Miloš Raonic. Welcome, everyone, to the SAP Open, one of the longest-running, most prestigious events on the ATP World Tour. I'm Leif Shiras, alongside a former Davis Cupper and a gentleman who played this event a number of times, Justin Gimelstob. Justin, the Australian Open is in the books. Great start for men's tennis. Now the guys shifting gear to the hard courts in North America. San Jose is the first stop.
Well, a very important part of the 2012 calendar. You have Masters 1000 and 500 events in the near future. Players want to get momentum. They know they're in North America for the next couple of months. They can hunker down, and it's a great start. This tournament has so much tradition, and the players love coming to Northern California.
Yeah, so many great champions here. Agassi, Laver, Sampras, McEnroe, and also some urging guys who made a move here. Michael Chang won his first title. Andy Murray, last year was Raonic, bagged his first title.
Yeah, this tournament just seems to be a catalyst, a real springboard for young talents to emerge. And last year, the story was all about the Canadian, Miloš Raonic. He got to the fourth round of the Australian Open, so he came in here with some confidence, and these were perfect conditions for him. Indoor tennis, first strike tennis, controlled environment. One of the biggest weapons in the game is his serve, and he rode that serve all the way to his first career title last year.
Yeah, he donned the Sharks jersey and raised the trophy. And someone who would like to do the same thing is Ryan Harrison. He's in his third ATP World Tour semifinal. He'd like to go one step closer, reach his first final, and he can get it done. He's a talented young player.
Well, he'd love to find the Miloš Raonic model exactly like Raonic did last year, breaking through. And Harrison has similar weapons off the serve and the forehand. Harrison and Raonic were junior rivals. Harrison had one of the biggest wins of his career last year, beating Raonic in Indian Wells. For Harrison, it's about managing his weapons. He's mature way beyond his years. He won his first match on the ATP World Tour at 15 years of age. He's been a pro for 4 years. He's very mature and solid. A very high tennis IQ.
Yeah, this matchup has so much in it. So glad you could be a part of our coverage from San Jose. Raonic taking on Harrison. These guys know each other well. We're going to get to know them more just in a moment. Semi-final coming up. SAP Open is brought to you by SAP, the best. Yeah, testing 1, 2, 3, 4. How did that look? All right. No blood. I think it was good. It's tough, isn't it? There's a lot of noise out there. I can't imagine what a basketball game is like down courtside. Yeah, I can hear you there. Okay. All right. So Raonic will be road two, is that what it is?
Hold on to it. I just want to just watch them over there.
Excellent. Okay. So after road two, we'll see him on court and then go back to Keys. Is that okay? Oh, okay. Thank you.
AP Open is brought to you by SAP. The best-run businesses run SAP. Welcome back, everyone, from the heart of the Silicon Valley here in San Jose. Semifinals of the SAP Open. It's Ryan Harrison and Milos Raonic. A look at the Canadian Raonic, who has had a brilliant run, not only this year, but last year winning the title. He hasn't lost a set, Justin.
Well, these are perfect conditions for his game. Controlled environment, no wind, no sun, the ability for his offense to overpower his opponents.
A big win over the South African Kevin Anderson there. Ryan Harrison, boy, did he have a road through. He was down a couple of match points to Robbie Ginepri, survived that second rounder.
Two excellent wins. Oliver Rokas, a hardened veteran, a Grand Slam doubles champion, just a tough out on the tour. And then another hard-fought victory against Robbie Ginepri, a former top 15 player and a Grand Slam semifinalist.
Some keys, Justin, for the Canadian, Milos Raonic, in this one.
He needs to work that forehand inside out. That's his big finishing shot. He needs to keep that first serve percentage high in court positioning. Get closer to the baseline. He has a tendency to drift a little far behind the baseline. For Ryan Harrison, the second serve return. You need to take advantage when Milos misses that first serve. Backhand down the line. Use that as a finishing shot. Be opportunistic when he does have those few chances on the rounded serve. This match is going to come down to a few points. Both these guys serve well, manage their service games very well. Whoever is more clutch in those big moments will be the one that advances to the final.
It's a great start for Harrison. A lot of first serves and a love service game to get out of the blocks. Harrison, who has served well here in San Jose. Incredible number of aces against Rokas. 27 aces in his first round match. So he's in a good service rhythm coming out of the Davis Cup. What does he do well on his serve?
Beautiful service motion. Nice shoulder turn. You can see it right there. Nice transfer of weight. Excellent knee bend. Nice high ball toss. Very fluid service motion. One of the best second serves in the sport already at 19 years of age. That's a great foundation to start from.
Yeah, big serve can help you get in the door, and then you have to build some complementary plays around it. And a chance to look at one of the biggest serves in the games. Raonic, untouchable on that delivery.
Set up by that inside-out forehand in the middle of the point, enabled him to bridge that gap between the baseline and the net. You'll see Harrison, he's going to use the slice backhand a lot, especially on this court. Try and keep the ball low, make Raonic bend and create his own power. That is an absolute missile. 143 miles an hour right over the low part of the net. And it's that easy, smooth power from Raonic as well. Just no extra moving parts on that serve. Very smooth and repeatable motion.
Service game for both men. Here's a look at that delivery, Justin.
Similar to Ryan Harrison. Nice shoulder turn, nice deep knee bend. Just explodes up and out into the ball. Very rhythmic. Nice high ball toss. This just has a live arm.
Yeah. And the toss doesn't drop at all. The sequencing is so perfect. Right at the top of the toss.
Love the way Harrison gets up to that short ball on the forehand. Really takes it early. Gives him more options, and he has excellent racket head acceleration. Brings the ball up and down very quickly.
Here's a look at his serve.
Look how quickly he moves up to the short ball. Right on the top of the bounce. That ball around the court, use the angle, changes direction, finishes up the line. It's really a multifaceted weapon.
Yeah, he plays with a little more variety, doesn't he, than Raonic. This one had some top spin, some angle to it.
Harrison's done a nice job developing all parts of his game. He's a true all-court player. That wide serve. The only match that Raonic has lost this year was against Hewitt in Australia. And Hewitt abused Raonic wide on the deuce side. Raonic stands pretty far behind the baseline. Gives you some space to hit into there.
Well, he made the difficult volley. Missed the easy one.
He did an amazing job on that half volley. Kept the racket in front of him. He's really pushed himself to learn and get more reps in the forecourt. Here's a perfect example. Nice stab, but he gets a little stiff on this forehand volley. Too big of a swing. Doesn't move to it with his feet.
So both men are clinging to their serves pretty confidently, impressively. And it's Harrison 2-1 up here in the opening set, the first semifinal from the SAP Open.
Raonic serving now in the fourth game. Trying to keep pace with Ryan Harrison. 1-2.
Harris did a nice job on that second serve return, getting up to it early. Ball really kicks out and away. You got to commit and stand inside the court before it gets too high.
It was the first double fault of the day. Justin, where do you measure this man's serve? You think of guys like Karlovic, Roddick, Isner. Where does his serve
rate? In that top five area, right amongst all those players you just mentioned. Isner right at the top.
Isner having such a brilliant win in the Davis Cup in Switzerland, picking up a significant victory. How would you describe that? Career win over Roger Federer?
Well, hopefully it's just the beginning, the breakthrough win.
It's all those good things potentially for Isner.
Harrison talked so much. He won his first Davis Cup match, even though it wasn't a live rubber. In the fourth match, got an opportunity to be part of that team as we take a look at the free-flowing service motion of Raonic. Davis Cup can be a real catalyst for players, especially young players. Once you deal with that type of pressure and come through, gives you a real level of confidence moving forward on the ATP World Tour.
Yeah, and you hear from Harrison a lot of the same things that we heard from Andy Roddick when he started off his Davis Cup career maybe 10 years ago. Harrison has that same passion for competition.
There's that inside out for him. Harrison does such a nice job. Similar to what Davis Cup captain Jim Curry would do on the forehand, getting up to it early, maintaining his options, nice footwork, giving himself some space, and then getting the inside of that ball so it trails away from his opponent. Spent a lot of time with Jim Curry picking his brain, trying to gather information on how best to execute that inside out forehand. Ryan is such a student of the game, even at a young age.
Certainly got one of the best of them in Courier, doesn't he?
There's that backhand down line we talked about. For both players, it's a pivotal shot. Both players like to hit their forehand from the middle of the court. So if they could execute the backhand down line, there's space to be had there. It's a shot that Ryan has worked on as a weapon. The backhand side really, it's the shot that has taken the longest and is the hardest, the least natural for Harrison.
Raonic making a direct attempt to get to that backhand, exposed it on that occasion.
Smart shot. Doing a nice job moving around, good footwork, getting the ball high and deep to the Harrison backhand. Trying to make Harrison create pace off that side above his shoulders.
So Raonic with a strapping of taper on that left knee, the one that he had so much problems with in Davis Cup. A little bit of a misdiagnosis, Justin, but he was able to right things here at the Stanford Clinic.
Well, at first, it was thought to be a tear. And he was obviously came out here, said they have great medical staff here at the Stanford Hospital. And they said, no, it's just some inflammation, just some tendonitis. So that gave him the confidence to be able to play. And he's looked sharp thus far. That is a very effective and underutilized serve in tennis. Excellent body serve there, especially against a big guy. Serve it right into his hip. Don't let him extend his arms. With this context, just totally handcuffs around it. Beautiful serve. Harrison has directed a lot of traffic to that Raonic forehand return.
Yeah. Well, tightest service game we've had so far. Harrison takes it. He also takes a 3-2 lead here in the opener. Raonic serving a 2-3. Beautiful ace right down the tee.
Nothing you could do about that. If Raonic hits his spots on that first serve, it's unreturnable.
145 miles per hour. Perfect location.
That's where Harrison does have a distinct advantage for two reasons. One, he has more margin on his forehand. Two, he's much more comfortable coming to the net than Raonic is. So if you get Raonic in those in-between areas, make him create his own pace, you could yield some errors. That's what Hewitt did so well in Australia in the lone match that Raonic has lost this year. If you get the opportunity to get into a neutral situation with Raonic on serve, you really got to fight to get him moving or get the ball into that backhand side. You can't let him hit from a stationary position from the forehand in the middle of the court.
Because you're not always guaranteed just to get into the rallies, are you, with thunder like that coming down at you? He gets very tall, doesn't he? 6 feet, 5 inches. Full reach up into the toss. Didn't miss by much, did it? Harrison teed up that inside out forehand, so it's three games all. No actual challenge there. Obviously, the system is in place. We haven't had one yet today. Of course, this is from the top half of the draw, this first semifinal. Julien Beneteau, the number 5 seed out of France. He's taken on Denis Istomin. Istomin out of Uzbekistan beat Andy Roddick in the quarterfinals. That'll be tonight.
Once again, utilizing that wide serve, and it doesn't have to be yield immediate dividends. Worst case scenario, it opens up the court. You know that you get Raonic moving on that first ball, and this is what Harrison does. Pops that backhand cross court, gets the outside of the ball.
done an excellent job managing his service games thus far in this match. Mixing up his serve, mixing up his locations, looking to dictate off the first strike when Raonic does get the return back in play.
The occasional unforced error off that backhand wing. 30-15. So here is our first challenge. Let's see what the technology tells us on the big screen overhead. Raonic saw it pretty well, didn't he? Second, sir.
Looking to dictate the forehand from their backhand corners, leaving space, daring their opponents to thread the needle down the line.
Yeah. Well, both men are serving well, aren't they, here in the opening set. Harrison, another ace, and it's 4-3. Ryan Harrison and Milos Raonic, semifinals from the SAP Open. Leif Sharris and Justin Gimelstob along with you for this one. First serve of any service game is so important.
So you said challenge, so.
Raonic is going to challenge that. And he didn't get right. So it's love 15. Slightest of openings here for Harrison.
Does such a nice job of piercing through the court on contact. I mean, it has that live movement similar to a pitcher where the ball just explodes out of the player's hand. had a little bit of an opening there. Those are those little mini opportunities they talk about when you're playing someone who serves so well. You find a little bit of space, you muscle the return back, put him in an uncomfortable position. Points like that, shots like that will determine this match.
That's a pretty good return of serve there. Here's another challenge, second of the game. Look at that last forehand from Raonic. Yep, he's missed both of the sidelines by a little bit in this game. 30 all.
Absolutely nothing you can do about that. The way he hits his spot, the way the ball turns, slides away.
Of Pete Sampras there when I saw that ball curling away. Of course, that's one of Milos's heroes.
Got an opportunity to meet him last year to play in an exhibition sponsored by SAP last fall, and that was a real highlight for Milos. He was completely starstruck.
Four games all, inching our way closer to a tiebreak. Of course, this event, such a rich history, started back in 1889, the Pacific Coast Championships at the old Del Monte Lodge in Monterey. It's made its way back through San Francisco and to San Jose. And you see some of the great champions who have played and dominated this event.
It's a who's who on that champions board. Laver, Sampras, Agassi, McEnroe. We also talked in the open where it's a real opportunity for young players. So many young players have emerged here. Andy Murray won his first title in a third set tiebreak against Karlovic, Raonic last year. Not so much about Raonic's serve, but Harrison has done such a nice job getting free points, mixing up location, paces, spins. We saw a body serve, did a nice job on the wide serve on both sides. That is just beautiful. That inside out forehand, using it as a catalyst to finish at the net. He continues to improve his game where he's more and more comfortable finishing at the net behind these big ground strokes.
And that forehand has a lot of pop, doesn't it?
Yeah, no, it has a lot of pop. It's getting bigger, but he's also taking it earlier in the bounce.
Yep, Harrison is there.
He's such a good athlete, moves so well for his size, very explosive. Spends a lot of time off the court getting stronger, fitter, faster. He knows that's so important in order to be successful. In this sport, if you're not a great athlete, you cannot compete at the top level.
Justin, you spoke about their first meeting on the ATP World Tour in Indian Wells last year. That was a three-setter and a tiebreak in the opening set, one that Harrison won. In fact, it was one of the best matches of 2011. It had great atmosphere and a little bit of a rivalry, two young players emerging. So that was a third-round match. Here's a semifinal. Official review. What serve and volley tennis, but Raonic had the answer, and it's deuce.
Always dangerous playing a player out to his forehand unless you really do damage, and Raonic just a little bit too much time able to manipulate that passing shot down the line. And when he had the opening, he committed to it and popped that forehand inside out.
So our first break point of the day, Raonic has it. There's the head-to-head, Ryan Harrison. Went in Indian Wells, but down here on serve, the biggest moment of this opening set. With an ace.
Points of the backhand down line. Both players utilized it in that point. And ended up being the finishing shot. Both players daring their opponent to thread that needle down the line. That's such an improved shot from Ryan Harrison right there doing the damage.
One reason why Novak Djokovic rests atop the men's game is ability to change directions, particularly with that two-hander up the line, which you say is such a critical shot in the men's game. So Harrison, that's a big game. Dodges the break point, moves ahead 5-4, opening set here in the semifinals. Look at Ryan Harrison up 5-4 on Miloš Raonic. And Harrison has done well on serve. Points won in red, lost in blue, and a good variety here in the grouping, Justin.
That's the most important part of the serve is mixing it up, mixing up your locations, paces, and spins. And Harrison has done a nice job with five holds thus far.
Thank you. Raonic with a nice forehand to take the opening point. Raonic has also served well. Look at what's happening when he gets his serve in. 89% of the time he wins it.
His favorite serves are up the tee on both sides over the lowest part of the net.
Net court.
And that's one of the next pieces for Raonic, is in those improvisational type parts of the court, close to the net, taking one hand off the racket. That's what Hewitt really exposed in Australia. The nuances of the game as he evolves, gets more mature, gets more reps in that area of the court. And that's why doubles be really good for Raonic to play a bunch of.
Raonic did play Davis Cup doubles alongside Daniel Nestor against France. Lost to Loder and Beneteau there, but again, you're right, those reps, little in-between shots, the doubles exposes.
14-15.
He's originally out of Montenegro. His parents emigrated to Canada. Dad Duzan is here with him in San Jose.
Yeah,
that's an awesome service game, isn't it? When he wins it quickly, delivers so many great serves. Of course, the man in the green sweater, that's Ryan Harrison's coach, Grant Doyle. Here's a look at that serve again.
Exceptional knee bend. Loose arm. Excellent wrist snap at the end. Gets the outside of that ball, so it spins away upon contact on the court.
He's 21 years of age, getting into his fourth year as a pro. Matching him step for step so far in this opening set when it comes to serving.
Said coming in that this match was going to be decided by just a handful of points. We have two excellent servers, indoor tennis, a young rivalry that's budding. Very small margins between these two. Look for Harrison, the big moments really challenge the Raonic forehand return.
Harrison out of Shreveport, Louisiana. Trying to get to 6-5.
Very confident start. Raonic will serve to try and stay in this second set when we come back to the SAP Open.
Time.
That's me.
Welcome back, everyone. Milos' father, Dujan, there on the right and on the left in the glasses, and blue jacket. That's Gallo Blanco, Canadiens coach.
A big part of Milos' development was done in Spain. You see the footprints of that when you watch him play. Really manages space, moves well for a big man. A lot of hard working with this player, former French Open quarterfinalist Gallo Blanco, lost to Patrick Rafter in four sets. Smart serve there. Harrison likes to hit the forehand on the second serve return. Milos just felt his energy move into the middle of the court. Milos goes for big second serves in big moments, similar to his idol Pete Sampras. He knows that the second serve needs to be a finishing shot and weapon as well.
Now here's a look back to that moment when he had a chance to meet the great one. Got a few inches on Pete, doesn't he? Oh!
Bringing that forehand up and down. He's missed a few of those in this match. He got up to it early, got that racket-head acceleration. That's the key part of executing that shot when you're close to the net.
Big delivery, isn't it? Just hammered down to Harrison's backhand side. The American unable to deal with that. So chance to get into a tiebreak here in the opening set. So Raonic takes his serve and tiebreak coming up here at the Shark Tank. Raonic also a strong athlete, pretty good mover for a guy this tall.
Moves very well, and he's imposing presence in the net. That'll be the next step in his development, is being more of a threat up there. More comfortable in these positions and tiebreaks. This is where Raonic has really excelled, especially in the SAP Open. Tremendous tiebreak record. Right there. Him returning well, manufacturing mini breaks, and serving so well in clutch. And that pressure he puts you under by virtue of getting so many free points on the serve.
Get into a tiebreak, you start feeling just a little more pressure. You see, Harrison was not happy with that error early in the rally. It's a daunting prospect to get your racket on these balls, even, much less get them back into play.
That is just absolutely impossible to return. The combination of pace, accuracy, and angle. Brownage just served really the total package.
In 2011, last year, as newcomer of the year, 22-12 in tiebreaks. So he got a lot of good business done at the end of these sets. And he's got Harrison under pressure, the American serving at love three.
And he's undefeated in tiebreaks in his career in San Jose, 6-0. Excellent opportunity to be 7-0. He's 4-0 last year, 2-0 thus far. The odds are heavily in his favor as we look at his father, Dusan, the engineer. He said that his son, had a chance to spend a little time with him yesterday, that his son was a math prodigy. At 16 years of age, he was taking calculus in high school. Never thought that he would be a professional tennis player, and neither did Milos. Wasn't a focus. It was just something that he improved on so drastically. It became inevitable. Nice opportunity there for Harrison to get on the board. He's got to stretch the court. Anytime he can get Milos into the corners, got to challenge him.
You wonder if that mathematics mind helps him calculate space and time and the geometry of a tennis court. I don't know if it helps, but sure looks like it might at times. Defend the net, so Harrison gets one of the two breaks in this tie break back. They'll change ends after 6 points.
4-2.
One of the best parts about Harrison's game, beyond all his physical tools, are the way he competes. Never gives up, always looking to solve the problem or the question that's posed. Excellent competitive instincts and desire.
As we mentioned, Raonic, the newcomer of the year last year. Harrison was on that ballot, making some nice moves, making some noise himself into the top 100.
That's a big delivery. That's just rearing back and beating your opponent with pace. 145 miles an hour, knocking the racket out of Harrison's hands.
Yeah, it's almost like a good baseball pitcher, as you like to use that analogy. A fastball right down the middle, deal with it.
Harrison doing a nice job getting, keeping this close. One mini break.
5-3. Raonic.
Change direction of the ball. His backhand is such an improved shot. This is an example of getting Raonic on the move, challenging him to defend the corners in the big moments. Catching Raonic late on that forehand side.
Well, you can cover up a few run forced errors when you can deliver shots like that.
Exactly right. That serve is an absolute eraser that he brings to the court. just mopping up unforced errors, protecting him.
Set point. From the big Canadian, Milos Raonic takes the first set, the tiebreaker, 7-4. So the number three seed, he's a defending champion. He's got the opening set on Ryan Harrison.
Thank you. Score date for set round each 7-6.
Back at the SAP Open, and a look at first set highlights between Raonic and Harrison, and a solid set of tennis. Like you said, Justin, a couple of moments, and that was it.
Not a lot between these two. Big serving, big forehands. Raonic just manufacturing that one extra point in the mini break in the tie break, continuing his streak in tie breaks here at the SAP Open. Seven straight now, yet to lose one in his SAP Open career. And that also comes with confidence, experience, self-belief, and the pressure he puts on his opponents because he serves so well in the big moments.
Yeah, he's a real force to be reckoned with. Serving first in the second set. He's getting that first serve in. It's tough to make an impression winning 85% of those points. Harrison went about 80% of his first serve points and defended the one break point we've had today.
It's demoralizing when you're playing against someone who just takes the racket out of your hand as often as Raonic does.
So Raonic takes the opening game in the second set, and now it's up to Harrison here to respond on his serve. And I know, Justin, you were able to spend a fair amount of time with Ryan in Los Angeles, and you found a lot of interesting things about him.
Well, last summer, right in the middle of his big breakthrough, we got to the semifinals at Atlanta, and then I had my summer show Holding Court with Justin Gimelstob, and we spent the whole day together. On the court, we mic'd him up, we practiced, we did a radio appearance, we did a long interview, and he's such a mature old soul. He's only 19 years of age. He's been on the tour since he was 15, the third youngest player in history of the tour to win a match at the main draw level in Houston, beating Pablo Cuevas at the U.S. clay courts, and really lives and breathes tennis on a day-to-day basis. And that's exactly what you want from a young prodigy, someone who's completely immersed in the art of getting better, whether it's physically, mentally, tactically. He's always thinking about what to do, what he can do to reach his potential.
He seems to go about it in the right way. He's one of these nice to meet you, sir, and thank you.
So respectful. Looks you straight in the eye. And that's a product of great upbringing. I mean, a family where they truly value respect and appreciation.
Am I sensing today, Justin, also that, you know, he seems to have an emotional control that he's working on as well? I know he's been known as something of a temperamental player, but looks like that's something he's working on as well.
He's mentioned that one of his goals for 2012 is to not get fined one time. He got fined a bunch of times in 2011, but really harnessing that emotional energy and using it as a positive instead of letting it bleed over and become a negative. Here's a look at that pretty service motion. Once again, nice deep knee bend, big shoulder toss. Shoulder turn, then getting the outside of that ball, spinning it away from his opponent. He's always conscious about calling everyone sir, being very respectful. Coach Grant Doyle, who helped the development of Sam Querrey and a lot of other young Americans.
As well as Raonic. Harrison's good defense, but obviously not good enough.
Serve. Picked it cleanly, took it early, got it back on Raonic quickly. Player. Played a little bit on the ATP World Tour level, mostly a challenger player, had some success in doubles.
Harris got a racket on that first serve, 143 mile per hour delivery. Trying to thread the needle up the line. As you mentioned, Sam Querrey, he was in the draw here, lost his first round match to one of the semifinalists, Dennis Istomin, in the opening round.
You fight so hard to get a break point, takes the racket out of your hand. First strike tennis, beats you on the serve. If you do get it back, pops that forehand. Very tough to get Raonic in a defensive position on his serve. He starts from such a position of authority.
Defensive lob, but what a smash from Raonic off the bounce, and he's off and running a set and 2-1 here at the SAP Open. What's going on there?
I do this because of the people. I do this because I love this.
New boats, gentlemen. New boats.
Demonstrates life. What can I do for you? Now what can you do for me?
It's the best feeling game in the world when you've taught somebody something and they get it.
I love it. There's no good. It's about helping others. And that's the main reason why TC can get it.
United States Professional Tennis Association, the world's oldest and largest association of certified tennis teaching professionals, has more than 750 professionals in Northern California. Call 925-478-9465 or go to NorCalUSPTA.com.
So here's Ryan Harrison serving now in the fourth game of the second set. Raonic with a forehand winner. I'm sure at the HP Pavilion in San Jose. It's a wonderful tennis community. Northern California really supports their tennis and been a big part of why this tournament has been around and has been so successful for so long.
Space to be had there. Once again, Harrison leans toward his backhand corner, looking at his forehand from the middle of the court. So if you could get a nice first strike there, there's space to be had. He's found it twice to set up love 30 in this game.
Challenge. Good news for Harrison.
Opportunity from Raonic. This is where the Raonic serve directly starts affecting his return games. By virtue of him winning the first set in a breaker, you're not getting a lot of opportunities on his serve. Any little hiccup on your serve creates exponential level of pressure to hold, because you know any mistake could be the end of the match very quickly. Case in point right there. Very tough to stay present and stay focused on managing your service games when you're playing someone that serves so well. That's the type of pressure that a lot of great servers have put on their opponents over the years. Sampras, Rafter, Roddick. Managing your service games and that cumulative pressure that is put on your opponents by virtue of your service games.
Wow, a double fault from Harrison. So Raonic now gets to 3-1, the first break of the day. East Palo Alto Tennis and Tutoring graciously thanks SAP for their charitable donation and for their continued support of the SAP Open.
It's just so live, 150 miles an hour. Don't adjust your TV sets. That is a calibrated gun, 150. Round, it's very similar to Sampras, just a total gunslinger. Wins a tiebreak, then blows the set open by virtue of just a couple points. And it's just an example of big time, big serving, shortening the margin type tennis that he takes directly from his childhood idol, Pete Sampras.
The record for first serve speed is Karlovic at 156. Raonic hit a 156, but it was a fault earlier this week.
Harrison has reverted to just pure guessing. That's how well Raonic is serving today.
Yeah, it's an impressive performance so far, handling an old rival from the juniors, now developing a new rivalry here on the ATP World Tour. Harrison off to a good start in this game. Now 30 love on his serve. Harrison knows the value now of every service point. A second break, and he's going to be shaking hands pretty soon. Needed that, and now he's trying to find a way to try and take a bite out of this serve from the Canadian.
This is where he just has to hope to get a few second serve opportunities and try and take advantage of those. Hard return into the roundage backhand. It's just not enough. When you do get that second serve opportunity, you have to do more with it because roundage is getting so many free points on the first serve. It's not good enough just to get the ball back through the middle of the court. Roundage doing such a nice job dictating off that first strike.
Yeah, you said deep to the backhand. That one was short to the forehand.
That gives Raonic more freedom on that serve. When you're defending your second serve as well as Raonic is, that's why the second serve return to serve and how you defend your own second serve is the most important stat in elite men's tennis. Besides the fact that Raonic has a great service merchant, when you give someone a get out of jail free card on the second serve on the first point, he wins it. It frees him up the rest of the service game. Doesn't make him feel any pressure if he misses that first serve.
It seems like Raonic is pretty attuned to the pressures you feel on the tennis court. In his presser yesterday, he used the word stress three, maybe four times, and how you deal with moments and how the score can influence the pressure you feel when you're playing. So he's aware of the stress that he can put on other players.
A lot of stress and duress.
Yeah, that's an awesome second delivery. 114 out wide, and he's 5-2 up.
Time.
Milos Raonic out of Canada, the defending champion. Check out the number of aces he's produced today. Six of those have come in his last two service games. Ooh, that's a nice little threaded pass.
It's a bit demoralizing when you're playing around. You're down to center break. It's tough to stay focused and keep that intensity when you're playing someone who's getting so many free points on service. It's really a demoralizing style of play to compete against. Where I'd love to see Raonic take some bigger swings, some bigger cuts. He has the break. He's up in this game. His feet are set. Go for his shots. That's a point right there. It might not be the difference of him winning this match, but that's what he's going to need to do in order to encroach that rarefied air, the top four, top ten. He's going to need to really be able to be dominant in all areas of the court, not just on serve.
Match points.
That's a beautiful serve right there. Hitting the spot.
Harrison was in the same position against Robbie Ginepri. Down a couple match points. He survived that. Can he do it again? He's facing another match point down here.
He had it lined up. The right shot there was right down the line.
Yeah,
you want to follow the action, keep the ball in front of you. Bit of a tactical mistake there from Raonic. Not just poor execution, but the wrong shot selection. That was not. That was perfect execution and the right shot selection, showing nice balance when stretched wide to the forehand.
Yeah, it's a good word to describe him for such a big man. He's got wonderful balance.
He did a nice job. Keeps his legs underneath him when stretched. That's the important part of executing shots when stretched in the corners.
And Raonic takes out Harrison in straight sets. So a moment for Raonic to celebrate 7-6 and 6-2. And as you can see, his dad was excited about this. So for the second consecutive season, he's going to play for the SAP Open title, yet to lose in San Jose. So he feels right at home, and so does his family.
Perfect conditions for him. Controlled environment. Enjoys this court. The ball bounces up right about his perfect strike zone, right about waist level. Seven clutch tiebreak wins in the 2 years here. Just plays with a relaxed confidence in Northern California. And a nice another step in Ryan Harrison's development.
Yeah, it's his third ATP World Tour semifinal. And no doubt he'll be back to take another big step, but he ran into a big opponent. Although Harrison did have that break point on the Raonic serve early in the second. Raonic delivered a thunderbolt that Harrison could not get back into play. But had Harrison been able to make some moves, he would have been in there. But Raonic never looked back.
We talked about the margins being very small with the style of play. Both players served well. Raonic was just a little bit better in every area. A little bit more experience in these type of matches in the latter portions of tournaments.
So it's a nice move for the Canadian. He'll await the winner of Julian Beneteau and Dennis Istomin from the bottom half of the draw here. Of course, Beneteau is the number five seed. Istomin out of Uzbekistan is unseeded, but you'd have to put Raonic in as the favorite in either of those matchups.
No doubt. His offense, the conditions, his ability to control his own fate by executing his offensive skills and his shots definitely puts him as the favorite tomorrow.
All right, well, we're going to have a word from our winner, but we're going to take a short break first here at the HP Pavilion. Raonic is into the championship, Mitch. Back with more.
Three, three, two, one. Check 1, 2, 3. This is Raj with Milos. 1, 2, 3. This is Raj.
And this will be arena wide.
Okay, we are now with Milos Raonic. First of all, congratulations. Very impressive today in the semifinals match.
Yeah, no, really what I wanted to do, I did really well out there. I took care of my serve, obviously. That's the most important thing for me. And after that, I think I played some good tennis. I executed on the few opportunities I had, and I was very fortunate to do so and just was happy to close it out.
At one point, you hit 150 miles on that service gun. Earlier this week, you hit 155, I believe. You're getting there. You're right at that record.
Yeah, I'm not thinking about it too much. The only time I really notice it is when the crowd makes noise, so that makes me look over. But it's something fun to do on the side, I guess, but it's a secondary objective. First of all, is to win.
Well, I know last year when you came in here, not many people knew about you, knew your name, but all of a sudden you win the tournament here in San Jose, and now once again you're in the final. Maybe San Jose is going to be your adopted hometown now.
Yeah, well, maybe I'll become the new biggest Sharks fan out there, but there's a little ways to go to win me over, but no, I'm really happy with how I'm doing here. It's fun. It's great. The people have been amazing. And it just feels awesome to come back to all these great memories and have it keep going on well.
Okay, so you're a young guy in your career. You're starting to really make your mark now. You grew up idolizing Pete Sampras. What about his game do you incorporate in your game?
I think the serve. No, just the aggressive mentality. Also, the demeanor is a big part of it. I try to stay pretty quiet out there. I don't try to show too much and just try to go about my business, and hopefully it goes well. And no, I idolized him. I got to meet him here last year, which was pretty special. So the memories and the good memory just keep building here, so that's pretty amazing.
It's one thing you need to work on in your own mind to make you even better than you are right now.
The return of serve. I think I've improved a lot this year compared to last year, and it's just getting better, and I'm eager to get better, and I'm going to do what I need to do to get better.
Very good. Milos, congratulations. Good luck tomorrow afternoon in the finals.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay, Milos Raonic here. A wonderful performance here in the semifinals. I'll send it, guys, back up to you upstairs.
All right, thank you, Raj, and what a performance it was. The last player to repeat here was Andy Murray back in 06 and 07. Raonic has a chance to do that. Stay with us. We'll come back and wrap things up from the HP Pavilion here in San Jose.
tomorrow, Milos Raonic will see him in the finals tomorrow. Best server.